In this video, we'll go through a Dynamo script that creates a perforated panel in Revit. We applied those scripts into Revit Family and extracted that and brought it for a laser CAD. And they have been cutting those. They have installed it so that you can see in the image how it looks in the final version. And in this video, I will be guiding you how the script works in step by step. Please comment below if you have been working computational design with Dynamo and Revit, and what kind of scripts have you been working on? So let's hop onto the video.
Before we get started with the Dynamo, I would like to share with you how we can use those panels in Revit. And you can see that they are really interesting. You can use for shading mechanism and you can use for many other purposes. However, this is one way of usage of it. So it's one shape that rotates and with a couple of attraction points. Or else, as I just showed you at the beginning of this video, an images, and these are the 2D printed versions of those images. So these were sent to the laser CAD, and we had those real life items and place it onto the house. So let's jump into Dynamo in order to get started with a script. Today we are going to discuss the script and how we are getting into the step-by-step procedure. But if you follow this video until the end, I will be also guiding you how to download the script, and it's readily available for you. So let's start with zooming in. And by the way, don't forget to download any of the packages if you need. So you can go search for a package and download one of those packages that are needed for this particular script. What we do is first we create 2 points in our coordinate system in order to get started with our model. So I will be showing you directly from the model side. So we have the 2 points. And then depending on the size of the geometry you're looking for, so 4 feet and 3 feet, I'm moving that geometry. So I'm having 2 more points on this side by this geometry, move geometry tool. So now I have 4 points. With these 4 points, I can combine all the 4 points from the list by creating a list create. And I will be getting a polycurve, which you can see over here. So, and then out of this polycurve, you can get a surface. I will be hiding these steps of the polycurve. Actually, I can keep all the polycurve steps. I will be hiding the surface area so you can see that. So next thing what I'm doing is I'm creating a boundary offset script because it's going to be sent to laser cut. Therefore, I don't want my cuts to be at the boundary. So I want a bit of offset out of that. If you want to be at the boundary, if you don't want an offset, you can always create it and then set the offset to 0, which would work the same way. But if you don't want that, you can exclude this script as well. It's up to you, but there is no harm by putting the script. So what I'm doing is basically I'm putting by moving the geometry 3-inch offset, you have the full script option. As I said, I will be sharing this script with you so you can jump into the more details, but I will be just fast tracking it because we will not have enough time to cover all the steps. So now I will be showing you here an offset version of it towards the inside, and I'm creating an attraction point that I want to control. So if I show the geometry, this attraction point can be moved within the boundary. What I'm doing is making sure that the offset boundary is set with some formulas. So I want to make sure that my attraction point doesn't go outside the boundary. So it's always inside the boundary. So if I go all the way down, it's in my boundary. If I go all the way to the left, it goes all the way to the left of the boundary. So what I'm doing next is that I will be just doing it randomly, placing it someplace over here. Next, I'm creating checkered pattern, meaning I am dividing the line into equal amount of grids. So in order to get a checkered pattern list. So here you can see that if I do this geometry intersect, if I show the geometry, I'm creating a checkered pattern list of lines. I can increase the grid and decrease by these values. So right now, if I want more values towards the vertical grids or horizontal grids, I can just change those values. Please make sure that this is an even number. So I'm starting with 2 and it goes every 2 steps. So it's always even numbers. There are no odd possibilities here. And this is really important. So when it comes to make the checkered pattern, I can use this to my advantage and create a checkered pattern by eliminating every first item. So once I have the checkered pattern, the next thing I need to get the diameter length. So I need to get the length between the verticals and horizontal spacing. But the question is over here, when I get the diameters over there, it is overlapping with the diagonal ones. So in order to get the diagonal length into account, I did a formula 45, 45, 90 degree formula triangle, and I'm building simply a triangle here and taking the 45 degrees, the value of that length, by and inserting that formula into the minimum as a minimum radius and maximum radius. So by the way, the minimum radius is just randomly created by the maximum divided by 2. So the formula gives me the maximum radius that I can go, meaning it will not intersect, so we're within this boundary. And the minimum is just personal choice. So if you want another number, you can simply do another number. So over here now, I'm taking a control with the attraction point. So that attraction point, I wanted to have a great control. So if I simply turn on this, you'll be able to see that I have all the dots taken into account. So I'm controlling all of them with the length. So if I get the length and use map to formula, so I'm taking a maximum length and minimum length out of those between the attraction points and all the checkered pattern grid. And then I'm taking the target maximum and minimum radiuses that I can get, and then I'm inputting that into circle value. So now I'm getting basically different radius of circles that will not intersect each other, and that will be always unique depending on the distance from the attraction point. So if I do the attraction point all the way up and to the right, it always changes. So that is kind of what I'm looking for. So let's move forward. If I go and show you the next step, what I'm doing over here is I'm creating a surface out of it and I'm giving a thickness to it. What I'm going to do is now the next thing is I'm going to get the surface into the Revit. So if I will not be able to share the boss screens here in order to not reduce the screen size. What I will be doing it, I will be showing directly in Dynamo, and in the end product, you will see how it appears in Revit. What happens here is that I'm creating solid geometries out of the circles, and then I created the surface out of my outside external boundary. With the help of this script, I'm simply cutting those solid geometries of circles with the surface. Once I cut it and I give a thickness to it, it happens to be have a thickness. So I'm hide all these, and then you will be able to see the thickness. The points, obviously, if I hide the previous items, all of them here, you'll be able to see directly the end product. Now, what I will be doing is that I will be just moving the attraction point front and back, and you will be able to see how it goes and it changes. Now, what I'm going to do is, you know, to exaggerate a bit so you can see the real value or real or more interesting values, I'm just adding here divided by 4. So I'm just going crazy with the closest points. And then now it gives you more kind of distribution of the proportions. If I move it up, I move it to the left, so you'll be able to see how it goes. And then as an end product, I'm getting it into Revit by using a package. Actually, I will be using both. So I will be seeing Dynamo, and then I will be seeing it in Revit. So to get in Revit, I use obviously a category. I want a generic model, I want a material, and I give a name to that component. In order to download the materials, contents, scripts, or to access any further information, you can hit www.integratedbim.com, and from there you can navigate to the blog, and from the blog post you can find the relevant post and download all the relevant materials. You can also find this information under the description of this video. Next week, I will be sharing with you part 2 of this video, where I'll be sharing more advanced options, how we can create different shapes, how we can create satellites, and how we can rotate those shapes depending on what we are going for. And I will be giving you a small screenshot where you can see what to expect next week. Don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel, because every week we are publishing at least one video for you. Don't forget to share this video with your colleagues. And comment below if you have any ideas or suggestions how to improve this further. By the way, if you forget to subscribe, next week you're not going to get a notification. So make sure you do so. See you next time.